Hey, our review family, keep it, I keep it tight. My name is Jay Morris, the review guy, reviewing music for the love of music, and I'm back again to bring you another video. Welcome back to Throwback Tuesday, my series in which I shine a light on some older releases that I think are definitely worth your time. I give a bit of some recommendations. And in this one, I will be covering the Tomb Warden record, Reflection of the Mistake. And right here, I just wanted to say this 7-inch looks great. Even if you just take a cursory look at the artwork and the lyricism, just like the 7-inch would entail, this record is dark and it's heavy. So Tomb Warden, if you are unfamiliar with the project, is a 3-piece Deathgrind and grind band coming out of Virginia, who have a very wide repertoire. They have a big resume and a very large back catalog of splits and demos. This record on the Bandcamp is self-proclaimed as the meanest death grind. And it definitely lives up to the title. This record lays into the guts, it lays into the gore, it lays into the grotesque. Anything that can be off-putting, anything that can sound horrific, they pack into these densely mixed and compressed mixes, where they're in and out in a flurry before you even understand what just hit you straight in the face. A very blunt, frontward-facing death grind release, and it also has a bit of a punk ethos, which, to be honest, the 80s grindcore scene was so heavily inspired by punk music and crust punk, with some of the figureheads of the genre, say Napalm Death, having a huge hand in the crust punk scene. So to see these lyrics that deal with war, that deal with the human condition and mankind as a whole, sometimes filtered through this misanthropic lens, it's not anything that hasn't been done before, but Tomb Warden does it in such a way that really lets you know, fuck you! On a track like Reality Plague, which doesn't even breach the 1-minute mark, on paper that is not any different than grind as a whole. Grind tracks notoriously are very short in the length department, but this track packs so much into that short runtime. They pack in so much noise and so much distortion, and when the track really does ramp up the energy and start going, it becomes so chuggy, it becomes this down-tuned, downtrodden mess that sounds so doom and gloom despite having a lot of anger to it and a lot of palpable rage. Each one of these tracks reading as these intense portraits of the band's mindset, accompanied by these chugging riffs, harsh, piercing distortion that will pop in at various intervals, and some gruesome drums. The introduction to Bronze Bull manipulates sound in a way that isn't too unlike a lot of noise grind bands, or just grind bands in general that like to generally open their tracks up with a lot of noise hitting you right frontward, but they just do it in a freaky, unique way. And that is another thing I want to commend, is the freakish nature of this record is surprisingly digestible. It isn't difficult whatsoever to really get behind the thematic elements, to really get behind the instrumentals here, because despite how rageful and in your face and just grabbing you by the throat and choking these mixes can feel, they just do feel very cacophonous and they do feel very chaotic and unmeasured, but also tangible in the intensity. It is surprising how easy it is to really feel what this band is trying to entail, feel what these instrumentals are doing, and honestly, some of these riffs are downright catchy at times. Like, the riffs stick with you, kind of like what you would get from a Nails. And I think a lot of that does in fact come from the fact that death metal is such a gigantic influence. I think if this was just a true blue type of grind record, it might not have the same level of depth and dimension to it as it does with those very chunky, chuggy death metal riffs that are interwoven very seamlessly with the grindcore sections that do go very frantic, that do go very fast-paced and keep the high-octane energy at a full throttle speed. As you're getting hit with these walls of sound, a lot of times it can feel a little bit subtle, it can feel a little bit vague, and this is the type of thing that you're going to either enjoy with a death grind release or you're not going to enjoy. In the future, I would like to see them maybe flesh out tracks even longer. They clearly have a keen eye for being able to pack these compositions out with a variety of ideas that really make them stand out from each track, and the ability to pack so much in short tracks makes me wonder what the band would be able to do if they push their links even further, if they push the boundaries of their own sound, if they would play around with length on a future project, or maybe even had more tracks to go along with it, because this is the type of record that just left me wanting more. Borderline, but not necessarily leaving a lot to be desired, but more so just making me want to ferociously consume anything else the band puts out. So if you are looking for a very grisly Deathgrind release that could fall in line with the meat and potatoes philosophy, the sort of one-dimensional playing style that is very classic and very hard-hitting and punchy, the type of thing that you don't like your records to be too cleanly produced, you like it to sound very organic, you like it to sound very raw, not too technical, just bludgeoning you in the face, check it out. I will put a pinned comment in the comment section below, per usual, where you can check out this band's Bandcamp, as well as where you can listen to this record itself. I do highly suggest it. But anyways, be sure to like this video if you enjoyed it, subscribe to join the review family today, and smash that notification button.